ChatGPT runs off prompts, and in this video, I'm going to share one of my favorite prompts for ChatGPT. You want better results? Try this prompt. And if you want a list of all my favorite prompts, you can go to AIupdate.ai to get that prompt. Okay, cool. So today we're going to be looking at the prompt evaluate. And the way I use the evaluate prompt is a way to assess the performance, effectiveness, or even the expectations of strategies and tools that I may be using, because our blind spots are our weak spots in life. So I'm gonna start off this prompt by just asking it to evaluate. So in this prompt, I'm going to ask it to evaluate my business marketing strategy. I wanna grow my barbershop and I want to run ads on benches. Now, just so you know, the longer your prompt, the more context you give ChatGPT, the better the results. And there's different ways that we can do this, but let's see what the results are on this business strategy. And what it's doing here, what it's saying is running ads on benches can be an effective strategy for a barbershop, but it should be part of a broader integrated marketing plan. Totally agree. You can't just run an ad on a bench and think that's gonna solve your marketing problems. Here's an evaluation and some recommendations for your business marketing strategy. Who is your target audience? Location-based targeting, yep. Ad design, in a clear call to action, promotions, all of that looks super, super, super planned. And now I love how this ends this. Would you like specific help with designing your bench ads or integrating the strategies into a cohesive marketing plan? Yes, please develop my marketing plan. And so what I think is interesting here is when I tell ChatGPT exactly what I want to do, I want to grow my barber shop, I want to run ads on benches, and when I ask it to evaluate my marketing strategy, it's like, whoa, 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 whoa. I need a lot more information. And by the way, whenever you're hiring someone into your business, they should be questioning you. I actually just brought on a new email marketer onto my team, and I told her what my ideas were, and she was asking probing questions. She said, well, I don't know about this idea. I need this information. What about your KPIs? What about your open rate? What are you doing for your deliverability? And she started asking questions. I'm like, you're hired. I wanna work with people that are gonna question my ideas and help me dive deeper. So again, what it's doing here is it's allowing me to dive deeper into my plan. Let's ask ChatGPT, and look at this. It even gives me an implementation timeline, all because I said, please evaluate my strategy of running bench ads to grow my barbershop. Do you not see how this might help you develop more ideas? And by the way, it says budget allocate. This is freaking bananas. This is, every time I open up ChatGPT, I am completely shocked by what it can do. And quite frankly, all of you as well, I'm telling you, you definitely wanna be involved in my 52-week challenge, where every week we're testing a new prompt in your life, in your business. Go to AIupdate.ai to get signed up for that. But look at this, it starts off by saying, your objective, target audience, brand positioning, unique selling proposition, brand voice. I'm talking to my barber, you need a USP. You don't have a USP, but you don't want to listen. You know, what are you going to do? Marketing channels and strategies, bench ads, online, social media, community engagement, promotions and offers. So crazy. But budget allocation. Then it gives an implementation timeline. An implementation timeline, review and adjust. This gives your whole market. And what I think is amazing about this prompt, and by this just quick exercise that you've seen here, is that you don't need to be an expert in marketing. You can let AI be your expert marketer. It just broke down an entire marketing plan, and you can just keep drilling down, copy and pasting this, building out your plan. It's also really powerful if you are in marketing, because what happens inevitably when you're using AI is it's gonna make some mistakes, or it's not gonna get as deep into a particular topic that as it potentially needs to be. And so as the expert in a topic, you can use AI to flesh out your old game plan, and then you can go in and pick it apart and say, no, we need to clean up this, we need to clean up that. So anyway, I think this is super, super interesting, great example. Let's try out a different example though. Let's say, for example, you wanna cut a few pounds, okay? And I'm gonna go at it again, right? So evaluate my weight loss plan. I want to increase muscle and reduce fat. Okay, so evaluate my weight loss plan. I want to increase muscle and reduce fat. I weigh 215 now. and I want to be 190. I'm going to run every day and stop eating bread. How does this stack up? ChatGPT, evaluate it for me. Evaluate it for me, right? To evaluate weight loss plan and provide a more effective strategy for increasing muscle and reducing fat, here are some key points and recommendations. I like how it does this. It clarifies current plan overview. And then it's bringing down some pros and cons here. Cardiovascular exercise, running every day. Pros, running is an excellent way to burn calories. Daily running can create a caloric deficit, which is necessary for weight loss. Cons, running every day without rest can lead to overuse injuries. Yeah, tell that to my left ankle. It might not be the most efficient way to build muscle. So all of a sudden I'm like, oh, okay. Let's talk about that. It says recommendations, incorporate variety, different forms of cardio. Right? Rest days include at least one or two rest days with low impact activities. Great. That sounds good. So it's saying, hey, let's maybe not run every day. Let's switch up our activities a little bit. And then strength training. Strength training is crucial. Plan, incorporate strength training exercises 3 to 4 times a week. Focus on compound movements like squats, deadlifts, bench press. So what I love about this, it also goes into diet too. Dietary changing, stopping bread consumptions, recommendations. Balanced diet, protein intake. Great. I didn't mention in my plan that I wanted to increase protein. Protein like chicken, meat, eggs, protein shakes, powder, stuff like that. And then it gives me a sample weekly plan. Morning, run for 30 minutes. Evening, upper body strength. I actually might use this plan. This is great. Tuesday, morning, HIIT workout. Evening, lower body training. So it wants me to go twice a day. Challenge set. So anyway, you can start to see how this can really, really keep you on track. Let's do one more example of the evaluate. Okay, so evaluate my financial plan. I want to have, let's say, $5 million. All right, so in this case, we're gonna ask you to evaluate a financial plan. I'm currently 35. I want to have $1 million for retirement by the time I'm 65. I put $5,000 into my 401k every month, and I'm paying off my $500,000 home. I have $5,000 in credit card debt and $75,000 in student loans. By the way, this is figurative, but I think probably a pretty common circumstance for young families. So let's say to evaluate your financial plan and provide recommendations to reaching your retirement goal, let's analyze your current situation and make adjustments where necessary. Look at this. Are you freaking kidding me? By the way, if you're in the financial planning industry, you can either sink under this or you can leverage this to become hyper effective, because the average person isn't going to fully understand this FV minus P times 1 plus R over N to the NT. The average person is not going to understand that, okay? Although it does the calculation for you. But if you're an expert in the field, you can leverage this type of information to become more and more and more effective. So what it's doing, addressing debt, credit card debt. Pay this off as quickly as you can save for a significant amount of interest. Student loans, look at refinancing options or vote for Biden. He'll pay it off for you, right? Not to get political, but... you know, he's paying, you get a free, you get student loan reprieve, and you get student loan reprieved. I see what you're doing over there. Consider allocating additional funds toward paying off his debts. What credit card? I don't want to go off a tangent here, but student loan and credit and student loan debt is the biggest freaking scam. It's such a ridiculous scam. You go to school, you get $150,000 in student loan debt. You're paying it off your entire freaking life. And by the way, even if you declare bankruptcy, it follows along with you. What the hell is all that? I don't wanna go off on that. We're talking about prompts here. I'm just saying, before you take out a bunch of student loan debt, do your research, all right? Do your research. So credit card debt, pay that off as soon as you can. Student loans, try to look at maybe refinancing for a lower interest rate. This is all sick, sick advice. Mortgage, make sure you're on a feasible payment plan. Extra payments toward principal can reduce overall interest. Also, mortgages, I'm not gonna go into the financer, but when you take out a mortgage, this is great advice. Extra payments toward principal, because the way it's structured is amortized. So when you start your loan, you're paying almost exclusively interest. By the end, you're paying almost exclusively principal. So this is just great advice. To reach your $1 million goal, which by the way, $1 million by the time you retire at 65 in 30 years is gonna be like not even remotely close to what you need to live a comfortable life. But anyway, that's a whole nother story. Increased 401k contributions, Roth IRA, taxable investments, emergency fund, budgeting. So it's helping me put together an entire budget. So what I love about this evaluate prompt is it sees my blind spots, right? It's asking me questions that I hadn't even perhaps considered. So the challenge here for you is to use the evaluate prompt, start testing it, see how you can improve your situation. Thanks for subscribing to the channel, by the way. Hugely appreciate that. And do yourself a favor and sign up for this 52-week challenge. Every week, I'm giving you a brand new prompt to test out, to maximize, to test with, so you can be an AI pro, so you can survive and thrive with AI. Go to AIupdate.ai and get your free, get in the challenge, baby, get in the game. I'm seeing people doing some amazing stuff with AI. That can be you too. Why can't that be you? It needs to be you. AIupdate.ai. All right, I'll catch you in the next video, right? Peace.